white supremacy is pseudoscientific. And a lot of you Negroes, you go to college like I did and get a doctorate degree like I did, and you start worshiping the white man's scholarship. That's what's wrong with half of y'all. That's what's wrong with half of y'all. Y'all worship the white man's science. Well, he said this, and he said this, and they found this. That ain't nothing but lies. The best way to get people to swallow a lie is to make it look scientific. You falling for that? You falling for that? You falling for that? All of you were conditioned. That's why when I talked about African spirituality earlier, when I said no religion is African unless it believes in ancestral veneration, y'all start saying paganism. Paganism, that's the devil. Because you were taught that. Anything that is not within the scope of the white man's Christianity or the Arab's Islam is paganism to you, because you are a Negro robot, a Negro bot. A Negro robot, a Negro bot. That's what your ass is. You on remote control. White man play you like he play Sega. He play you, this is you. He ain't even got to be in the hood. He got this. He played Negroes like this. Tell you what to do, how to do it. And see, this is why I like to point out that I use my real name. I'm not hiding behind some fake Egyptian name. Like most of these Hotep Negroes, they don't use it. You don't know what their name is. They could be pedophiles for all you know. You don't know. Criminals, you don't know what the hell they done done. They reinvent their life with a fake African name. I'm Umar Johnson everywhere. I'm Umar Johnson on Instagram. I'm Umar Johnson on Facebook. I'm Umar Johnson on Twitter. I'm Umar Johnson when I'm evaluating your kids. I'm Umar Johnson when I'm at the prison. That's right. I'm Umar Johnson when I'm battling Europeans. You know who I am. Okay, I ain't got no fake name hiding behind a fake name. I'm real. My life is real. You should try being real. It works. Number seven. White supremacy is pseudo-scientific. This one is important. This one important. White supremacy is pseudo-scientific. What does that mean? What does that mean when I say white supremacy is pseudo-scientific? When I say white supremacy is pseudo-scientific, what I'm saying, family, is they love to tell you that what they believe has been proven through scientific research. Stay with me. This is important. When you study the rise of racism, you will find that it was the scientists who created it. Apartheid in America was created by the white psychologists. Apartheid in South Africa, created by the white psychologist. Adolf Hitler's master race philosophy came from Joseph Goebbels, a white psychologist. They're scientists. They use their scientists to create lies and then conduct pseudo research to try to justify. Okay? They conduct pseudo research to try to justify the lies that they teach. If you remember, in slavery, during the Maafa, they said they had evidence that proved African people were half monkey. They had evidence that proved that we were half devil. They had evidence that proved that our brains were deformed. This is what they taught. And nobody questioned it because they said, we have the research. We have the research. 50 years ago, they said African children are intellectually inferior to white children. You say, how do you know this? We've done the research. Anytime you tell, Ebola came from a monkey. AIDS came from a monkey. How do you know AIDS came from a monkey, Mr. White Man? Because our scientists have done the research. Our scientists have done the research. Hey, Mr. White Man, there's certain things that we shouldn't eat. It's not good for African body and African DNA. You should not even sell these things. People should not even be allowed to include these ingredients in food. No, it's okay. It's perfectly healthy. How do you know? We've done the research. And so they have been able to get people to back off of challenging their conclusions, because every time you challenge white folk on what they believe, they bring out their fake science. They bring out their fake science. And we got Negroes in the conscious community. We got Negroes in the conscious community running around asking Dr. Umar Johnson, where is your research to prove ADHD ain't real? Asking Dr. Umar Johnson, the top black school psychologist in America, where is your research to prove learning disabilities don't exist? Where is your research to prove that there's a school? This is what you Negroes do, caught up in the white man's science. Caught up in the white man's science. We need to see research. They said, we read Dr. Umar Johnson's book and we didn't find any studies. You know why you didn't find no damn studies? Because I've been doing this for 20 years. I am the damn study. I don't need no white man from no university to support my findings. I speak the truth. As African people, our bar is not research. As African people, our bar is truth. We stand on truth. We don't stand on no research. Just because you put it in a book and say you conducted some controlled trials don't make it the truth. That don't make it the truth. They've been pushing pseudoscience on African people since the beginning of time, and you got the audacity, and you got the audacity to question my information. I was attacked a couple weeks ago by a light-skinned supremacist scholar who said I don't include no research in his books, but he include research in his. Well, if he want to quote white folks, he can quote white folks. I'm unapologetically African. I believe in self-determination. I will never quote them. I don't have a need to quote them unless it's absolutely necessary. Unless it's absolutely necessary. I've been doing this for 20 years. I know what I know. I've standardized tests. I've conducted evaluations, thousands of them. Why? With my expertise, with my history, with my background, with my experience, why do I need to go see what they're saying at Syracuse University? Why do I got to go and get information from a white man to prove what my own African intelligence has revealed to me over the course of 20 years doing this work? Get your ass out my face. Get your ass out my face. So how do we know what you're saying is true, Dr. Umar Johnson? I tell you what you do. You conduct a survey. You go across America and you said, are there any parents here who has taken the advice of Dr. Umar Johnson? Are there any African parents who have taken the advice of Dr. Umar Johnson for your child? Can you please tell us the outcome of following his advice? I got a 100% record, House Negro. I got a 100% record, House Negro. 100%. When parents do what I tell them to do, we win. Period. Point blank in the story. That's your research. That's your research. White supremacy is pseudoscientific. And a lot of you Negroes, you go to college like I did and get a doctorate degree like I did, and you start worshiping the white man's scholarship. That's what's wrong with half of y'all. That's what's wrong with half of y'all. Y'all worship the white man's science. Well, he said this, and he said this, and they found this. That ain't nothing but lies. The best way to get people to swallow a lie is to make it look scientific. You falling for that? You falling for that? You falling for that? The best way to make your lies look like truth is to make people think it's scientific. Please, see, you will never win this war politically, economically, culturally, socially, intellectually, spiritually. You will never win this war until you educate your own children. And do you want to know why? Why can I sit here and say, as a master educator, that you will never win this war until you educate your own children yourself? You know why I say this? Because one of the first goals of education is to make children of the victim loyal to children of the oppressor. One of the first rules of education is to make the children of the victim loyal to the children of the oppressor. So until you get your children's minds back, take all of this we see, all this madness amongst our youth from Barack Obama's homosexuality all the way on down, all of this is the result of black people not taking the educational destiny of their children into their own hands. How are you going to keep sending your children to his schools? They're being taught sympathy for his agenda. That's why black people will fight you when you talk about white folks. They will fight you when you talk about racism because they were conditioned to do that. All of you were conditioned. That's why when I talked about African spirituality earlier, when I said no religion is African unless it believes in ancestral veneration, y'all start saying paganism. Paganism, that's the devil. Because you were taught that. Anything that is not within the scope of the white man's Christianity or the Arab's Islam is paganism to you because you are a Negro robot, a Negro bot. A Negro robot, a Negro bot. That's what your ass is. You on remote control. White man play you like he play Sega. He play you, this is you. He ain't even got to be in the hood. He got this. He played Negroes like this. Tell you what to do, how to do it. Principle number 11. White supremacy. Its systems, its institutions, its leaders, its men, its women, its religions, its schools, its churches. Nothing in its system, nothing can be trusted. The minute you begin to trust a white supremacist, its church, its religion, your boss, its jobs, the courts, the cops, the minute you begin to trust white supremacy is the minute they begin to destroy you and everything you care about. Trust is the weapon. Trust in American democracy. Trust in American justice. Trust in white Jesus. Trust in Barack Obama. Trust in Donald Trump. Trust the system. That's what bourgeois Negroes always telling you. Trust the system. Yeah, the police shot him, but they're going to do an investigation, and that investigation will let us know if the police unnecessarily took his life. Trust, trust, trust. Who the hell you know with any common sense trust their enemy? Who do you know with any common sense is going to trust their enemy? You do not trust white supremacy, its agents, or its institutions. You do not trust white supremacy, its agents, or its institutions. The minute you begin to trust is the minute they begin to destroy you.